Jack's tree was screaming, "Kill him, kill him." What is the meaning of 105 North Tower? So here, said Defarge to the trembling officer. When Jack caught one of the officer and asked him about the North Tower, so Jack's tree was screaming. What he was screaming, "Kill him, kill him." So Defarge inquired about the meaning. What is the meaning of 105 North Tower? The meaning, is it a prison or a cell? A cell, sir, a cell. The officer, the trembling officer, responded over them. The prison officer led them up stone step to the top of one of the tower, and with a large key opened a door which led into an empty cell. So they all were asking about the prison where Dr. Manette was kept over there in the North Tower. So 105 North Tower means the prison, the cell in which Dr. Manette was kept over there. So the officer, he took them there in the empty cell. A straw bed lay against one wall, and there was a stool and a table against another. High up near the ceiling was a narrow window. Defarge turned to Jack's three. So Jack's three and Defarge, they both went into the cell that was there in the 105 North Tower. Search everywhere. So there was a bed, there was a straw bed on which Dr. Manette was laying. So search everywhere. So they wanted to search about the prison of Dr. Manette. As Jack's three was shining a light around the walls, Defarge cried, "Stop there. Look, Jack's A.M. Alexander Manette." And here he wrote, "A poor physician." So on the wall, Dr. Manette has written his name, Alexander Manette, and he wrote, "A poor physician." Actually, they were looking there for the proofs, gathering the proof for Dr. Manette over there. The two men tore the straw from the bed and searched everywhere. They broke the worn out furniture and even grubbed through the ashes left by the long dead fire. Before leaving, they set fire to everything they would burn. So they were searching everywhere about the proofs, okay, for the Dr. Manette, how he was kept over there. So the two men tore the straw from the bed and searched everywhere, and even they broke down the furniture which was kept in the cell, and even then they searched through the ashes left by the, and after searching everywhere, they left that space and burnt everything. Down in the bloody street, the only calm soul in the screaming mob was Madame Defarge. So when they came down in the bloody street, they saw only one soul was very calm. That was Madame Defarge. She was holding a knife in the throat of terrified officer. You know, she is not showing any kind of emotion. And when they came down, they saw Madame Defarge was holding a terrified officer. When she saw her husband, she spoke the last word the officer would ever hear. Means after that, she killed that officer. "Look, here comes my husband, Jax," and told the officer that my husband is Jax. Before that, she was not ready to reveal about the identity of her husband over there. She plunged the knife into the officer's neck, and as the blood gushed from the neck, she proclaimed, "Now you are paying for all the pain you have caused." So they were against the authorities of the French because they were underestimated by the higher authorities, and they were not giving them chance to stand along with them. So here, that's why Madame Defarge told her that you have to pay for the pain that you have caused to the poor people over there. So here you can see, dear students, how they were searching into the cell over there, Jack's three and Defarge. Next, soon after, the starving mob began hanging guards from the lamp post in the frightening display of the public contempt. The scarecrow of Paris danced around the swinging bodies like merrymakers at a summer festival. So after that, the starving mob began hanging guards. So they started hanging the guards, okay, on the lamp post in a frightening display. Means the scene that was quite scary over there when they all were hung down on the lamppost. The scarecrow, the hungry people, the thin people, they were started dancing around the swinging bodies of those all guards over there. Like the merrymakers, those who dance in the summer festival. It was exactly 14 years after the barrel of the wine had fallen off the cart outside the Defarge's cafe and someone had scribbled blood on a wall. So this happened, this revolution happened after the 14 years. You know, in the second chapter also, the scarecrow, they were running after the wine. So this scene was happened after 14 years. Not long after these events, Jax 5, the workman, was resting by the fountain in the village of the murdered Marquis, where another Jax joined him. "How are the things, Jax?" asked the workman. "Bad. No dinner today then? Only supper now. It's the fashion. So when is it to be? Tonight we meet here." So soon, long after this event, Jax 5, who was a workman, he was resting by the fountain in the village where Marquis was murdered over there. So here he was inquiring about the condition. So he gave the answer that very bad. And how was their condition? They are not getting anything to eat and no dinner today. Then it means there is no dinner, only supper, means only one time meal they could get in a day. So it was there. It has become, it's the fashion, means it has become their daily routine. So when is to be? And tonight, that night only they are going to